Hello guys, this is Leo the Wise, giving to all men, their needed uprise.
Hello men, dear MGTOWs. Here is an article from the Reddit forums within the MGTOW section. It talks about showing the veil behind the curtains. Women feministic behavior enhanced and boosted by the wealth of a few betrayers of their kind. Yes, a few men. I thought it to be interesting to hear, so that's the reason to that content. Sharing info and awareness is primordial to men going their own way. Let's dive into it. Critical thought, rich men behind feminism. The idea that feminism comes from women's minds is a little bit superficial and stupid if you really believe that feminists are just a few whores who want to ride the cock carousels and therefore they seek liberation for such things. You're wrong. They don't need feminism for that. The real origins of feminism doesn't come from women. It comes from men. Rich men. In 18th century, when people revolted in France, something very important changed. The church lost its power. Before revolution, there were mandatory 50, I can't remember the exact number, days off work, not to mention weekends, and they were all related to religious and cultural events, all supported by the church power. Then the revolution happened, bourgeoisie came up, church went down, 50 off work days were gone because they were related to religion and people didn't want anything religious anymore. So men had to work almost 2 more months, 50 days, approximately, and the bourgeoisie made way more money than before. And then this new idea came up, women must work too. Religion usually discouraged women from working, and encouraged them to stay at home and take care of children. The bourgeoisie saw the opportunity. Now that people don't religion anymore, they shouldn't want women to stay at home either. Bringing women into workforce in disguise of anti-religion modernism was the very beginning of feminism. Now you see that a man alone can support his family today, especially if he has children, thus the woman has to work as well to provide the family. Yes, the salary gap between men and women was removed, but in expense of lowering men's salaries, not increasing women's salaries. Now the actual people who are benefiting from feminism are the rich people who own companies and factories. This is why media supports feminism, because rich people control media and they want to make more money by using women's labor as well. You will see in the future that child labor will become normalized just the way women's labor did in the future. Children will go to work too. The age of consent will be reduced a few years, and also the age of employment, all because of rich men. The man-hating lesbian branch of feminism is just a byproduct of this environment, but the real people behind feminism are not women but rich men. Now you see the divorce laws, a man loses his house and half of his assets. The truth is, rich men want us to work till our last breath. Look at Hollywood, see how many movies they make about divorce and single moms? They are feeding married women with this idea that if you get divorced, you will be happier, and most women believe that too. But what happens if a divorce doesn't happen? An average man by the age of 50 has a house, a car, a good pension account. He wouldn't need to work after 60 because he has enough money by that age, but when he gets divorced, he has to start from zero. That means he will have to work a few more years to get where he wanted to be in the first place. So instead of 60, he has to work even through his 70s. This is why adultery has become the norm. This is why a lot of porn companies are making free videos of cheating stories, and a lot of websites like Ashley Madison are supporting having affairs. And the worst part is that registration for women in these websites is free, so her husband won't find out by checking her credit card. They want to break marriages to make men work more, which means more money for today's bourgeoisie. So this gynocentric laws, divorce laws, feminism ideologies, they all come from rich men, not women. And radical feminists are just a distraction to make sure people won't discover the truth. And now here we can see that a lot of MGTOW brothers have become rather misogynist. We can see all the time this avult all over MGTOW posts. Avult is true, but it's just a distraction to make sure people won't pay attention to rich men behind feminism. Don't let media fool you. The real feminism is supported by rich men, not women. Don't blame women for every bad thing that happens to men. Sometimes, it's the ultra-rich men who want to hurt other men. Now what does any of this have to do with MGTOW? It's this, go your own way. Avoiding relationships isn't going to make sure you're gonna be free at 60. MGTOW people need to learn how to minimize their expenses, how to save up more money in the long run. The purpose of MGTOW must be freedom of corporations, not relationships. Avoiding relationships is a good strategy, but it doesn't guarantee your freedom. Men need to learn financial rules and laws. They need to learn how this game works, They need to understand how the corporations play with money and workforce. Men need to understand that they shouldn't work forever. They shouldn't become corporational slaves. They need to work for a limited number of years, save money, then get retired in peace of mind when the time comes. Feminism is cancer, but ignorance is worse.
And that is it for now. If this content was entertaining and interested you, please share, like, and subscribe to this channel. I am the Swan, leading men till dawn, and even beyond. Thanks for the audience.